Quran chapter 33, verse 56, lesson 2615. Title is Salutation and Compliment. Chapter Al-Ahzaab, the clans. I seek refuge in Allah from Satan, the outcast. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Lo, Allah and His angels shower blessings on the Prophet. Grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him. O ye who believe, you should also send blessing on him and salute him with a worthy salutation. Commentary. Previously it was commanded that you should revere and honor the Messenger of Allah Almighty. Grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him. Its way was described that you should bear in mind that he should never be grieved or harmed by your any act. The same matter has been explained in this verse that the Muslims should ask Allah Almighty to confer blessing upon him and ask Allah Almighty to grant him peace. By this, his love will increase in their hearts and they will follow Allah Almighty and his angels, peace be upon them. By this act, because Allah Almighty himself confers blessing upon the Prophet, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him, and his angels, peace be upon them, to pray before him to do so. It is commanded, Allah Almighty keeps his sight of kindness upon the Messenger, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him, mentions his excellences in Holy Quran, proclaims about his magnificence and dignity, and his angels ask Allah Almighty mercy for him constantly. O people who believe, you also should join in his reverence and respect according to your capacity. At first, you should obey his all sayings and follow his entire deeds. After that, you should send blessing on him and salute him with a worthy solution. With a worthy salutation. The companions, may Allah be pleased with them, said, O Messenger, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him, we have learnt the way of saluting, that is, sending salam upon you, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him, from the prayer that when we sit for reciting attahiyat. In it we say, Assalamu alayka ayyuhallaziina wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Describe us now the way of sending blessing, that is salat, to the Messenger, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him, taught them durood-e-ibrahimi, which is recited in the last position of sitting in prayer, that is qada, after attahiyat. Durood-e-Ibrahimi, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Translation: O Allah, let your blessing come upon Muhammad and the family of Muhammad as you have blessed Ibrahim and his family. Truly, you are praiseworthy and glorious. O Allah, bless Muhammad and the family of Muhammad as you have blessed Ibrahim and his family. Truly, you are praiseworthy and glorious. The famous companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Hazrat Kab bin Ujra radiyallahu anhu, narrates that once it was inquired from Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam as to how blessings should be sent to him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied that the blessings be said in the manner it has been mentioned above, that is, Durood-e-Ibrahimi. It also comes in understanding from the sayings of the Messenger, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him, that when his name is called, we should say along with his name, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Briefly, we should recite often, as-salatu was-salamu ala rasulullah. Urdu mein samaat farmaiye, unwaan hai durood o salam. A'udhu billahi minash-Shay-taanir-Rajiim. Bis-Millaahir-Rahmaanir-Rahiim. InnAllaaha wa malaaikatahuu Yusalluuna alan-Nabiyy. Yaaa, ayyuhallaziina aamanuu, salluu alayhi wa sallimuu tasliimaa. Allah aur uske farishte Rasool sallallahu alaihi wasallam par rehmat bhejte hain. Ae logo jo imaan laaye ho, rehmat bhejo us par aur salaam bhejo us par. Isse pehle Rasoolullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki taazim aur takreem ka hukm hua. Uska tarika pehle ye bataya ke khyal rakho ke koi baat tumse aisi na hone paaye jisse aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ko dukh ya ranj pahunche. Is ayat mein usi par izafa hai ke musalmanon ko chahiye ke nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam par durood aur salam bheja kare. Isse aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki mohabbat dil mein badhegi aur durood bhejne mein Allah subhanahu wa taala ki aur uske farishton ki pairvi naseeb hogi. Irshad hai ke Allah tbarak wa taala apne nabi kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam par rehmat ki nigah rakhta hai. Aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki khoobiyon ka zikr Quran-e-Majeed mein karta hai aur aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki azmat aur shaan ka izhar farmata hai. Uske farishte aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke liye Allah subhanahu wa taala se rehmat talab karte rehte hain. Ae imaan walo, tum bhi apni haisiyat ke mutabik aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki taazim aur takreem mein shamil ho jao. اول تو آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے پورے پورے فرمان بردار بنو اور پھر آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم پر درود اور سلام بھیجا کرو. صحابہ رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ نے کہا، اے رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم، سلام بھیجنے کا طریقہ تو ہمیں معلوم ہو گیا کہ التحیات میں السلام علیکہ ایوہ النبی و رحمت اللہ و برکاتہ کہا کریں. صلات کا طریقہ بھی بتا دیجئے. آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا کہ آخری قعدہ میں التحیات کے بعد مجھ پر سلام بھیجو. اس کے بعد وہ درود سکھایا جو التحیات کے بعد پچھلے قعدے میں پڑھا جاتا ہے. یہ بھی احادیث سے سمجھ میں آتا ہے کہ جب آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کا نام لو تو اس کے ساتھ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کہو، اور جب بھی موقع ملے آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم پر درود اور سلام بھیجتے رہا کرو، جس کے سب سے مختصر الفاظ یہ ہیں، صلی اللہ علی نبی محمد و علی آلہ و صحابہ وسلم. صلات کے معنی ہمارے واسطے یہی ہیں کہ اللہ سے محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم پر رحمت بھیجنے کی دعا مانگا کریں. اس کے فائدے بے شمار ہیں، اور ایک دفعہ دل سے درود پڑھنے والے پر اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی 10 بار رحمت کی نگاہ فرماتا ہے. صدق اللہ مولانا العظیم و صدق رسولہ النبی الامی الکریم.